We are right along the Tennessee River here in Knoxville, Tennessee, and there's an exciting football game that's about to start. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Tennessee is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Ball State's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively, but when you've got a wide receiver like this, it really helps them.
It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups, and when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup, and if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. Nice run there. Steele picks up about 4 yards on the play. They make the stop at the 41-yard line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. He keeps it and picks up maybe a yard. They can't hook up. Incomplete. It's third down. 9 to go. Ball on the 42. Going deep. Can't connect. Tyler was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Snyder is waiting for the snap. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Gives it up the gut. Nice run, and he's brought down. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He's finally tackled at the 38-yard line. Oh, that was one beauty of an option by that quarterback.
No question. There was no hesitation whatsoever. Once he saw that hole, he turned it upfield and left everybody in the dust.
First down and 10 to go after the big gain on the run. Drill at the 28-yard line.
That's great execution. The quarterback made a nice throw, and the receiver was able to go up and make the play.
Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up.
Mike seven.
Here we go.
Three and a half.
Throws complete. He's hammered. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Brought down around the 3-yard line. first and goal from the three. Let's see if they can muscle this one in. It's power against power right now on the field. Both teams have their jumbo sets out there. Small, left side. He's tackled at the seven.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
Here's an opening. Touchdown, Tennessee. The quarterback just made that one look pretty simple.
Well, this quarterback isn't your average player. He runs the option very well and keeps this defense fits.
And he hits the PAT. It was a 7-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
And it was really those long runs that really helped propel that drive.
So the score now, 7-0. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 21. Tennessee's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Scrambling around. He's out to the 30. And down he goes at the 36. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Strike to the receiver. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, it's a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice gain.
There's a play fake. Now he's going to run and watch out. There's a very impressive open field tackle. First and 10. Ball on the 33. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room a little bit earlier. Good to see him back on the sideline, and it looks like he could be returning to the game. Fires to his tight end. Nothing doing. Third down, and they need to get it to the 23. Him hard at the 27-yard line. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he nails the long field goal. Ball State is lining up to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
Quick throw. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Tennessee is up by four. And he's hit immediately.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
Gets it. He's in space. Tackle at the 27. A tight, low-scoring game in that first 15 minutes. Let's see if things open up in the second quarter. The Volunteers in front, 7-3. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game. Go back to him on a quick throw. Tackle made at the 24-yard line. From the 24-yard line, it's second down. And now he pitches it, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 20. Zips it to the back. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. So it's the running back who shows off his hands on the touchdown.
It's such a bonus to have a back who can contribute to the passing game.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all. He makes the PAT. So that's a six-play, 74-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of center.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's going to try and scramble. Bounces off a would-be tackler. They'll make the sack.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out in practice, they told us that there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, you better get back to that drawing board because these defensive ends are just too quick.
In second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 23. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Scrambling. They'll bring him down at the 39. Good awareness on that scramble there.
They dropped everybody back in coverage and left enough running room for the big guy to get a first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39. Pulls down the catch and he's got room here. Fires quickly to the tight end. He's knocked out of bounds around the 49-yard line. Taken down at the 46.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. They can get some protection. They might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
And here's another third down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Jackson, back to return it. He really got a hold of that one. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He sheds it, and he's level at the 38-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. And he's tackled at the 41. It out to about the 44-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Offense lines up in a five-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. He's scrambling. And he's taken down around the 46-yard line. Push him out at the 42. Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 42-yard line. And they make the stop around the 32-yard line. Got his tailback. Brought down at about the 27-yard line. From the 27-yard line. Second down. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Caught, open field. He gets hit out of bounds at the 13. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 13-yard line. On the ground, he won't get back to the line. The Volunteers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Here's the 11th play of the drive. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five-wide outlook. They hook up over the middle. He's tackled at the 4. They come out on an empty backfield. He gets sacked on the play.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
This isn't much more than an extra point. It's up, and he's got it. We've reached halftime, and I don't think too many people were expecting this. 17-3, Volunteers.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Ball security was a major theme coming into this game, and both offensive coordinators have to be thrilled with the fact that their offenses, first and foremost, did a good job of taking care of the ball.
And you don't see it every game, that's for sure, that both teams don't have a turnover at the half, and you usually see those critical mistakes that set up a short field for you to take advantage of, and it's definitely nice. It's nice to be able to put in a plan all throughout the week and to be able to execute it and not to be able to make those big mistakes, because coaches will tell you, it's those big mistakes that kill you. It's okay to be rushed in the pocket as a quarterback and then throw it to your mom in the third row. Don't throw it in harm's way. Both quarterbacks done a good job, and as a result, both teams with zero turnovers in the first half.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter.
Nice kick, plenty of distance.
From his own goal line. Across the 30.
They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line.
They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Fires it out.
And down he goes at the 38.
From their own 38-yard line, it's second down.
Now he tries to buy some time. He lost the ball, and the defense is on it.
A lot of guys in the defensive backfield are ball hawks, and the safety showed it there by pouncing on the football.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Little screen pass. Tackle at about the 39-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 39. Tackle made at the 28. Scrambled. They'll bring him down around the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, second down. He's on the run. He's taken down at about the 13. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Throws complete, and he's hit right away. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
He's under pressure, and he is drilled at the 18-yard line. How about the intensity of the pass rush?
These hits take a toll on a quarterback, physically and psychologically. The blockers have got to do a better job of taking care of them.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. The kick is up, and it is good. Ball State lines up for the kickoff. He'll return it from the one. What a collision! Last time the offense had it, they lost a fumble. So I'm pretty sure the coaching staff was over there talking about ball security.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
He's pushed out of bounds at the 45-yard line. First and 10. Ball on their own 45. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. It's incomplete. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Nice run, and he's brought down. Scrambling around. He's at the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 28-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's tackled at the 24. Corner makes his way out to about the 15. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 15-yard line. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked. It's the ninth play of the drive.
Larry. Mike six.
He makes it to the 18-yard line. So we're looking at another third down here. Under heavy pressure. And he tackles him hard at the 7.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
So they've moved him back, and it's 4th and long. So with one quarter remaining, Tennessee leads it 17-6. back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
He gets it up, and it's good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish, whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to their opponent's territory.
He gets to about the 41-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. Complete and taken down immediately. And Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
He's going to try and scramble. He's wrapped up for the sack. They need to get it inside the 49. And he's taken down at about the 49. Fights forward to about the 46. From the 46-yard line, it's first down. Swings it left. He's got his fullback. And they make the stop at the 41-yard line. This play is number 8 on the drive. He gets rid of this one. And again, they're going for it on fourth down. There was some movement on the line.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Throws it and it's tipped away.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Up the middle for a nice game. Small picks up 5 with the carry. From the 49-yard line, second down, less than 3 minutes in the game. And he hits him hard at the 47.
Come on, oh, come on, oh. 7 to Mike, Mike 7. Ready!
try to just force something there. Just good, hard running for the first down.
From the 41-yard line, first down. Brought down right around the 40.
And he gets a yard on the run.
There was simply no daylight on that play. The defender came in and dropped the hammer.
He makes his way to about the 32. Ball State's called their final timeout. They'll spread the field with five wide. Now he's scrambling. And he's level at the 21-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 21. Makes it out to about the 13. This is the eighth play of this drive. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He'll go down to one knee. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Paul's impact on today's game, Kirk, we were expecting it to be on the positive side. Unfortunately for them, it ended up being a negative.
Yeah, definitely a tough loss to swallow. Typically, you'd like to see some other players step up and kind of help the cause when your great star player doesn't have an outstanding game. But in this case, I don't know if it would have made much of a difference.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.